In this problem, we're asked to find the quadratic function given the intercepts of the function. So because we're given the intercepts of our quadratic function, we're going to first find the function in factored form, and if we need to, we can multiply it out so that it's in general form. The factored form of a quadratic function with zeros r sub 1 and r sub 2 can be given by f of x equals a constant, times a factor of x minus r sub 1 times the factor of x minus r sub 2. Looking at our graph, notice how we have an x-intercept of negative 4 and x-intercept of positive 3. So x equals negative 4 would be a 0 of the function, and so would x equals positive 3. So if our function in factored form is in the form of f of x equals a times a factor of x minus r sub 1 times a factor of x minus r sub 2, we can substitute negative 4 for r sub 1 and positive 3 for r sub 2. So this would give us f of x equals a times x minus negative 4 becomes plus 4, and x minus 3. Now we can use the y-intercept to determine the value of a. If our graph contains the point 0, comma 6, this means f of 0 must equal 6. When x is 0, the function value, or y, must be 6. So if we substitute 0 for x, this function value must be 6. So f of 0 would have to be a times 0 plus 4 is 4, and 0 minus 3 is negative 3. But this must equal the function value of positive 6, and now we can solve for a. We would have negative 12a equals positive 6, divide both sides by negative 12, and we have a equals negative 1/2. Therefore, our function in factored form would be f of x equals negative 1/2 times the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x minus 3. This would be the quadratic function graphed here with the given intercepts. Of course, if we needed to express this in general form, we would have to multiply this out. But for this video, I think we'll go ahead and stop here.